Cheryl Blossom, Riverdale's very own red hot lesbian Barbie who always seems to be on the verge of a mental breakdown. When Cheryl said that she owns red, what she meant to say is that she owns red flags. But what Cheryl does get a pass for is her iconic one-liners, which we will be putting to the test to see if any fellow singles will fall for this scream queen.
Toodles.
Hello, singles. I'm Cindy from the YouTube channel With Cindy, and welcome to Flirting with the Enemy, the show where Netflix pays me to bully innocent singles.
The balls on this guy to be just so upfront about being a douche. I was like, okay, well.
In each episode, I go undercover as an iconic character with a mean streak to see how many red flags people will ignore for a pretty face. This week, I want to see if people would swipe right for their high school bully. This is Flirting with the Enemy, Cheryl Blossom. Now, I know Cheryl is the sapphic queen of Riverdale, but for all of our villains in the series, I made both male and female profiles. Cheryl obviously isn't located in LA, so for her profile, I said her hometown was Rockland County, which was my closest geographical estimation of where Riverdale is actually located. And of course, I listed most of her occupations: cheerleading coach, painter, property manager, slash entrepreneur. Somehow, I still managed to leave off gang member, maple farm owner, rum distributor, and cult member.
Feel free to tremble.
Okay, bio. Listen up, fives, a 10 is speaking. I'm a bombshell, which means I need no reasons. I simply am. Send me a message if you can keep up and want a little sweet to go with your sour. I'm honestly so proud. It's as if Cheryl wrote this bio herself, cherry emojis and everything. Mwah. All right, next is a section called Last Time I Cried, which I filled in with a direct Cheryl quote.
The answer is a double cherry on top, no.
There's just no way Cheryl willingly reveals her trauma to a bunch of hobo losers who can't get dates. No freaking way. What she will reveal is her pet peeve. I like that we say, oh man, to express disappointment, because men are, in fact, disappointing. Obviously, this is too perfect, so for good measure, let's plant a big old red flag in the middle of this profile.
I invented red. I am red.
The craziest thing I've done for love. Arguably, one could say that digging up the corpse of your dead brother and talking to it for weeks on end is pretty crazy.
Welcome home, JJ.
But that might be too crazy, even for this show. So let's just say the craziest thing I've done for love is sent them a pig's heart. LOL, well, sort of. There. Perfect amount of batshit. I'm now ready to find the Tony to my Cheryl.
I'm in the mood for chaos.
Oh, singles, are you ready for your match? Cheryl matched with three dates, and during all of our chats, I spoke exclusively in direct quotes and references from Riverdale. My first potential suitor is Bennett, a man who is actually 6'4", a former pro volleyball player, and can count cards. Let's see how he feels about meeting the queen. I'm gonna introduce him to a little game called Secrets and Sinners. I'll start the game with you. Have you ever been unfaithful? Oh, he sent me a voice memo.
I didn't lie to you, I have been unfaithful, and it's definitely not something I'm proud of, and I learned a good lesson from it. I think it's made me a lot more picky about who I really choose to give all my energy to.
You did a bad thing, Daddy.
And now everyone knows.
The truth always comes out. I'd rather have a clean conscience than be a guilty liar. Daddy's not perfect, but he does it pretty damn good. Ugh. That's how we get him, folks. That's how we fucking get him. All I had to do was call him Daddy, and that reeled him right in. But will he stay interested if I tell him this? Well, I did burn down one of my family's homes with my mother in it. Unfortunately, the wench survived. I got another voice memo. Okay, let's see what he has to say.
So, it seems you're a little crazy, which is kind of hot. but how crazy are you?
So why so many voicemails? Like, do you not know how to text?
Well, I think it's more of a personal touch when you send a voice note.
Oh, I definitely got the personal touch from you. Is there anything you wouldn't do to get laid?
It's a good question. You know, what's funny, actually, I know I'm very flirty, but I actually, by choice, didn't have sex for a long time.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's why you're acting this way during our chat.
You know...
You have to make up for it, right?
Maybe I'm just a tease, though. Who knows if I would have actually, gone through with it. Yeah.
He's into crazy girls. We got him, folks. I already know how this shit is gonna go.
I'm cuckoo bananas for you, Humphy.
Bro, saying I'm cuckoo bananas to a guy I just met is not having any kind of game. At least not one that ends with you alive. This seemed like a good place to end the chat, so our trusty Netflix producer asked Bennett privately if he thought it was going to be a match. Hey, Bennett, so is it a match? Yeah, sure. She's a wild thing. Kinda into it.
Where are we going and how extravagant a wardrobe should I pack?
I hate my choices, but if I have to choose one and only one, it'd be fuck. I like how Bennett is like, oh man, this is so hard. But if I had to choose, only one and just only one, I guess I would fuck her. You guess, Bennett? You guess? Please tell your dick you're playing Flirting with the Enemy, not Guess Who. Are you usually this aggressive and calling yourself daddy?
You called me daddy first, okay?
Yeah,
okay,
but
so...
that seemed like it was part of your common vernacular.
You know, it's funny. I actually just got asked that question, do you like being called daddy? And I said no.
Why are you giving me like totally different answers from our chat? Like everything we just shared to each other was a lie now.
I don't even know. No, I mean, you can like...
You wouldn't bang me after all. You don't like being called daddy. I don't even know who you are as
I know,
a person.
I know, that's the beauty of being an actor.
Hands off, Gollum.
Let's talk to someone who's more Cheryl's speed, AKA a lady. Lindsay here is from Bucks County, Pennsylvania. Okay, no offense to the good people of Bucks County, but I don't know where the hell that is. I have been informed Lindsay is actually in a relationship and she's straight. Excuse me? I'm supposed to be the one doing the catfishing here. So let's see if Cheryl can smell a hetero in disguise.
Challenge accepted.
Hi there. Hi. To what do I owe this unannounced pleasure? I am here to talk to you about your car incurable options. Insurance, asterisk, asterisk. Well, damn, now it's not funny. I ruined the joke.
Did you have a lobotomy for breakfast?
I just made myself a ranch water and pet a dog with bad breath. What on earth for? For fun, duh. And then she attached a photo of a dog from some horror movie that says, I have bad breath. Lindsay, what the hell is this? What were you trying to do here? Is this how you think lesbians flirt? So, I guess my first question is, why are you straight? Would you ever want to be in the FBI? I was born for this moment. And no, cops are hobos. I would only be an agent if I could be Austin Powers, getting bad guys and getting laid. I can smell the hetero through the screen. I'm over it and Cheryl is over it. Our producer swooped in to release me from this hetero hell and asked Lindsay if she thought it was a match. Def no. I couldn't keep up with the banter. Not sure it's my style, but she's fun.
I need girls with fire on my squad.
So you did say that you wanted to ghost me because I was a little bit too much. But is there anything that Cheryl could have behaved or said that would have made you change your mind?
Probably not calling me a hobo.
That was a joke, you hobo. Right.
And a welfare baby?
Yeah, most people aren't into that.
I'm sorry I called Jughead a hobo that one time.
I wonder why Cheryl's not your style. Maybe it's because you're actually straight. If you don't fall for your high school bully, are you even gay? I'm gonna need a drink to recover from the queer erasure of that entire conversation. But until then, let's talk Tyler, our next victim. Tyler is self-described as chunky, funky, and ready to meet the man of his blackouts. He's a weed delivery driver and part-time speech and debate coach. and Cheryl ran a maple-run business as a minor, which, unlike weed, is still illegal in all 50 states. I'm in the mood for chaos.
Want to team up for a little destruction?
You know it. What did you have in mind? Overthrowing the patriarchy? Playing Gaga and dancing in front of bigots? Or discussing how Taylor Swift is overrated? I didn't catch your name, Mr. Chaos. I'm LA's it boy, Jason. If I'm playing Mel Cheryl, I might as well go with her dead brother's name. So what was going on through your head when you were chatting with me? I feel like you thought I was just doing a bit.
Oh, absolutely, right? Yeah. I thought, I was like, what? Twofold, actually. I was like, oh, this guy is like way pompous and like such a douche, but like what? The balls on this guy to be just so upfront about being a douche. I was like, okay, well.
Any questions for moi? Tell me about a time you lied to save your ass, but it ended up blowing up in your face. I was infatuated with someone in high school, but they were dating a troglodyte football player. So to scare a suitor off, I left a pig's heart in my beloved's locker to make it seem as if it came from the other guy.
Oh my God.
Unfortunately, I was caught. Subtle. I love it. Very Edgar Allan Poe meets Jeffrey Dahmer. Any questions for me?
I know everything I did was legit crazy.
But I was wrestling with some dark, Carrie White-like demons. Didn't we all? Why do I feel so comforted? That was quite clearly a psychotic breakdown being understood and supported. So you said like you love fixing damaged people. Has that worked out for you?
Not once, not ever. But,
I suspected
you know.
So, yeah. Without too much prompting, Tyler got back to us with what can only be described as a manifesto about our chat. Allow me to read for the class. I can't fully say it's a match just yet, but I'm excited to meet him. His life sounds like it was ripped from the pages of a CW drama. I'm very interested in seeing what else is there.
I think she's crazier than a serial killer on bath salts, but so what?
Yes, my life was ripped from the pages of a modern day CW drama, yet I somehow still talk like a Victorian heiress.
Some people say it's retro. I say it's eternal and iconic.
But what if like I was for real? Like what if this was a dude and he legitimately had all these fucked up things going on? Would you still be into that?
I mean, I said I would, so yeah, probably.
Tyler, please.
I know! Listen, my therapist knows very well that it's a problem and I'm working on it. But,
okay, good.
You know, you gotta do what you gotta do, okay?
All right.
I'm just a big girl trying to get some, I was gonna say get a nut, but I don't know if I could say get a nut on this channel.
No, you can't, you can say whatever you want.
I'm a big girl trying to get a nut, so there you go.
I understand completely. Yeah. Well, I'm sorry that I'm a girl, but
okay.
I think Cheryl would stand.
I think so too.
Well, here we are, still single, but left with the knowledge that being a hot redhead with a trust fund will always trump arson and pig murder. For the rest of you swiping right tonight, watch out, because you never know when you could be flirting with the enemy.